Hello guys, this is One Man Dev and I'm starting a tutorial series on how to create a pixel art 2D action RPG game from absolute scratch. This series will be targeted towards absolute beginners. So you don't need any prior experience with Unity or any other game engine. But I will expect you to have at least some form of programming experience. If not, don't worry, it'll be covered on the way ahead. Anyways, with that out of the way, let me show you what we'll be working on in this series. So as you can see, we have a very simple 2D game where the player can walk around and interact with the objects. I can swing my sword around and destroy these bushes. And as I destroy this bush, it'll have some random chance to drop loots which the player will be able to pick up into their inventory. I haven't implemented this feature just yet, so we're destroying the game objects as the player glides. We'll also cover how to create a simple creature AI, like this cat for example. I made it so he'll randomly walk around these red dots as you can see here. He also has a relationship system. So if you make friends with him, he won't run away from you. And he will definitely annoy you to death if you don't feed him in time. Anyways, there's another great feature we'll be covering as we go along with this series. One of them are Unity's built-in auto tile feature, which will allow us to build our levels very efficiently. Cause you probably know how painful it is to create maps one tile at a time. Well, no more, because with the help of Unity's rule tiles, we can automate the process. As you can see how I'm painting away with auto tiles and Unity is doing the heavy lifting for us. You can also make fences this way so they will snap into place when you put them side by side. So as you can see how easy it is to work with Unity's auto tile feature. We'll also cover the use of scriptable objects as data containers so the data doesn't get destroyed when player is trying to switch between different scenes. So let's get straight into it. And here I am on Unity Hub. I'm just going to create a new project. And here I'm using Unity version 2021.3.11 F1. But you can use a earlier version or a later version, it won't matter. And I'm gonna create a 2D game. I'm gonna name my game Top Down 2D RPG. You can name it whatever you want. And then hit create project. And it's gonna take about a minute or two depending on your specs. Now that Unity is done building our project. And now if you go to your scenes folder inside your assets directory, you can see that Unity has created a sample scene for us. I'm simply going to rename my main camera to camera. And if you were to change the scene name, you can do it from here. You have to locate the scene file, then rename it from here. It's gonna tell us to reload. And if you take a look at the hierarchy window, you can see the name of our scene has changed. And now we're going to import all our assets. I'm going to leave a link in the description where you can download all the assets from. Just download it as a zip format and open it up on your file explorer and extract it. Now we are going to drag the artwork folder into our assets directory and it's going to import all the assets automatically. Now that we have our assets imported, I'm just gonna drag a player idle sprite. You can find it inside your players slash idle slash idle front and let's just drag that into our scene. And if you zoom in, you can notice that it's very blurry. And now to fix that, we have to select our player sprite. And now in the inspector tab, we have to set the filter mode to point no filter and compression mode to none. And if we hit apply, we can see that it's much better. And I'm going to set the pixels per unit to 16. And I'm also going to name it to player. Now if we hit play, we can see our player standing on a blue background. And now we'll add a simple two directional movement to our player. And to do that, we have to add a rigid body 2D component from our inspector. And we have to set the gravity scale to 0. Otherwise, our player will fall right away. So I am setting gravity scale to 0. That way, our player won't be affected by gravity. Now I am going to make the player move according to our input. And to do that, I'm going to go back to our assets directory and create a new C# script. And then I'm going to attach the script to our player. Just select our player and drag it into this inspector. And then double click to open it on Visual Studio. And right now, as you can see, we have two little functions. One is start and another is update. Now the start function only runs on the first frame, while the update function runs once per every frame. I'm going to show you what I mean in just a second. I'm going to print two new lines, one on the start function and another on the update function. And now if we save and run Unity, you'll see a whole bunch of new lines on the console tab. So I'm going to stop the program and show you what's happening. So as you can see, our start function ran only on the first frame and the update function ran every single frame. And now if I create a variable called counter and increment it once every time the update function ran, then we can print it out to the console exactly how many frames has it rendered since we started the program. And now if we run it, you can see exactly how many times the update function has run. Now I'm going to delete them just real quick, because we don't need them anymore. And now I'm going to target our rigid body. I'm going to create a public float value called move speed and set the value to 5f. And I'm also going to create a vector 2 called velocity to know which direction our player is moving. You can name it move direction or whatever we want, but I'm gonna call it velocity because it makes more sense this way. And I'm going to make the velocity to vector 2.0 because we want to set how much our player has moved to 0. Once per every frame. Now we'll have to set the X velocity to horizontal input value and we'll set Y velocity to vertical input value. And we're using input.getAxis raw instead of input.getAxis. Is that because we don't want any acceleration when we press WASD keys? Now if you run the game and hit WASD, then you'll see which input values we are getting. And finally, we're going to move our player. I'm going to create a new function real quick called fixed update. And inside, I'm going to target the player's rigid body. Plus, I'm going to add which direction we are moving. Then I'm going to multiply the value by the player's move speed. And then I'm going to multiply it by time.fixedDeltaTime. And multiplying by fixed delta time is very important, otherwise the player's move speed will be affected by the frame rate. And now if we save and hit play, nothing will happen as we play WSD keys. That's because we have to refer to the player's rigid body in our script inspector. Now just drag the rigid body component into the player script extender and hit play. Now as you can see, we're able to move while we press the WASD keys. So that's it for today. If you like what you see, then hit the thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't. And in the next lesson, we'll be adding directional animation to the game.